A very good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss very very important topic, that is scientific method. Important topic ani endukannanante ye scientist aina sare ye problem aina sare how they solve it, they use this particular method called scientific method. Scientific method gurinchi ee roju discuss cheddam. Scientific method lo important steps untayi, important 7 steps untayi. First step is identifying a problem, and because of observation we have to identify, we can identify a problem. Then second step is asking questions. You have to ask a question, then forming hypothesis, planning experiment and conducting the same planned experiment, drawing conclusion, generalizing it and investigating it further. All these steps are very important, and we will discuss about each step one by one. First step is observation and identifying the problem. Observation is the key role, plays a key role in scientific method. So you have to observe your surroundings with keen and ease. So you can identify a problem which you can solve using scientific method. For example, in this case, you wanted to grow some beans in your backyard. How you will solve this? Next is asking questions. You should ask questions about what you have chosen to solve. Okay, here our question is, we are confining to one question: which soil works best for planting bean seeds? Okay, let us solve this. Let us find out. Third one is forming hypothesis. What is hypothesis? Hypothesis is very important. A possible answer that can be tested is called as hypothesis. It should be written in a complete sentence. Okay, let us now write an hypothesis for what we have chosen. My hypothesis is that bean seeds sprout best in potting soil. Then we have to plan experiment to find out whether our hypothesis is correct or not. Planning a experiment, we should write the stepwise procedure, and we should identify the variables. What is a variable? Variable is a factor that can affect the outcome of an investigation. There are several variables in our experiment also. For example, variables are also two types. One is a fixed variable and another one is changing variable. Changing variable must be controlled. Controlling variables can limit the outcome of an experiment. So here in our case, we are taking three kinds of soil: sandy, clay and potting soil. We are testing it. So water and light here are fixed variables. We cannot change them. They are commonly provided to all the bean seeds. And what is changing variable here? Changing variable is the soil. In one case we are taking sandy, in one another case we are taking clay, and in another case we are taking potting soil. Okay, so we should conduct a fair test for your hypothesis, and let us see how the experiment goes. We have to conduct the experiment. Whatever procedure we have written, we have to follow step by step. This is very crucial step in scientific method. So these pre-planned steps must be implemented practically, so we need sources for that. Now we are going to make observations after conducting the experiment. Now we are going to observe these bean seeds germination for 9 days. During 9 days, what is the outcome? So for example, for sandy soil, after 9 days the plantling grown for 3 centimeters, in clay soil 2.3 and potting soils 3.1. so my hypothesis is that potting soil is best for planting bean seeds. But the outcome result, now the next step is analyzing that data. Whatever we have got, we should analyze it and we should draw a conclusion. Now after observing this one, we have seen that the bean sprouts are growing both in sandy soil also, potting soil also. So my hypothesis is not correct, because the plant bean seeds are growing best in sandy soil and as well as potting soil. So we are analyzing this data and gathering a conclusion. Okay, next, if this hypothesis is correct, we have to go for another question and solve it. If the hypothesis is incorrect, we have to go back and we have to test the hypothesis further. Okay, here in my case, the hypothesis is not correct. It is also growing best in sandy soil also. Now next one is, we have generalized that thing and now we are investigating further. Now my new hypothesis is formed. My new hypothesis is that bean seeds sprout best in a combination of clay, sandy and potting soil. Okay, so this is a scientific method. We have to again plan for experiment and the process repeats. Remember, any scientific outcome will not end abruptly. It won't end abruptly. It should rise to new questions, because science is an unlimited ocean where we can find new questions, find new results, and this is an endless process. Okay, and best research do not end abruptly. It should rise to new questions. It should rise to new innovations.